Hi friends, welcome back for the third and the final session on leaf, right? In this last part of our discussion today, we will talk about modifications of leaf. Right? We've already seen two earlier videos on leaf. This is the third one. See, I've divided the discussion into different videos, so even you get an idea on how to structure and how to divide your discussion. How do you learn? Right now, you take it up part by part. Right now, you memorize, you make the first part thorough, and then move to the next part. Right now, so this is how also you can divide your study. You know, when you were doing the structure appropriately, right? Now we talk about modifications. We've spoken about modifications of root earlier. We've spoken about modifications of stem last time. In fact, 15 modifications we spoke about stem. Here we talk about leaf modifications. Now, in one of the discussions earlier, if you remember, right now, humne jab last time bulb discuss kiya tha. Right now, bulb mein I had made a small mention. Right now, ke the food is stored in the leaf basis there, right? Na? So, वहाँ पे मैंने बताया था कि that should actually come under modification of leaf. So, please bear that small point in mind, right? Okay. Now, the first modification that we take is leaf spine, right? In the stem part last time we discussed about thorn, right? वहां पर मैंने एक छोटा सा ब्रीफ मेंशन किया था कि थॉर्न अलग है, स्पाइन अलग होता है, प्रिकल अलग होता है, राइट? तो अपने यहां पर डिस्कशन में वी हैव थॉर्न एंड स्पाइन इन दिस चैप्टर. सो थॉर्न इज अ मॉडिफिकेशन ऑफ स्टेम एंड स्पाइन इज अ मॉडिफिकेशन ऑफ लीफ, राइट? नाउ हाउ टू डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन द टू, राइट? लास्ट टाइम जब हमने थॉर्न का डिस्कशन किया था तो मैंने आपको एक इमेज भी दिखाया था, बताया भी था कि थॉर्न के ऊपर यू कैन हैव स्ट्रक्चर्स डेवलपिंग, क्योंकि स्टेम का पार्ट है, राइट ना? तो उसपे भी नोड्स वगैरह हो गए, राइट ना? सो थॉर्न इज अ पार्ट ऑफ स्टेम, और यू कैन हैव अ बड डेवलपिंग एज अ थॉर्न, एक्सिलरी बड बिकमिंग अ थॉर्न और अपाइकल बड. वी सॉ कैरसा ड्यूरेंटा एंड ऑल दैट, बोगनविला वी सॉ. Either the apical or the axillary bud becoming a thorn. Now, leaf spine, where the entire leaf becomes a spine. Ye bhi discussion humne last time had the phylloclad mein, opuntia. Yaad hai ki nahi? You have to reduce the rate of transpiration, and to reduce the rate of transpiration, the leaf is knocked off, and that's why the stem overtakes, right? Stem takes the responsibility of doing photosynthesis. Now, let's check the examples where the leaf becomes a spine. The entire leaf is modified into spines, right? So, these spines that you see are nothing but they were once leaves and now been as spines. Now, how can you tell that this structure was a leaf? The green part dekh rahe was stem mein. It has become green, right? And does photosynthesis. It's actually phylloclad. Right, but हम लोग यहाँ spine के point of view से कर रहे हैं. So if this was a leaf, that means it is arising from a node. मतलब ये जो point जहाँ से वो आ रहा है, I'm just marking it here. That is a node. अगर node है, leaf है, मतलब angle होना चाहिए. Angle है मतलब axil, axil है मतलब axillary bud. Right ना? So the presence of an axillary bud will indicate that yes, this structure is a leaf, and that is how we can differentiate between a stem and a leaf. A thorn or a spine may differentiate kar sakte hai, right na? Now, right, thorn axillary bud ka modification hai, yahan par leaf modify ho raha hai, theek hai? Okay, next is the margin of the leaf becomes spiny, right? Only the margin of the leaf becomes spiny. Have a look at this agave, right? Can you see the margin becoming spiny here? Again, the purpose solely remains the elimination or reducing the process of transpiration, right? Third is stipule modifying into a spine. A stipule, right? Starting mein aaya tha, main bataya tha, stipule ke modifications aayenge. Stipule becomes a spine. इन केस ऑफ अकेसिया, राइट ना, ये देखो अकेसिया, राइट। अब अकेसिया है ये वाला, स्टिप्यूल इज बिकमिंग स्पाइन। ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ अकेसिया लेट मी शो यू दैट दिस इज द लीफ ऑफ अकेसिया, राइट ना, ये उसका रैचेस होना चाहिए, राइट। कंपाउंड लीफ दिख रहा है अपने को, वाओ, मतलब ये लीफलेट था, अब लीफलेट भी डिवाइड हो गया है सब लीफलेट्स में, मतलब ये कौन से टाइप का लीफ होना चाहिए? अगर एक बार पिनर डिवाइड होता तो यूनिपिनेट, लेकिन ये तो दूसरी बार डिवाइड हुआ है, मतलब अकेसिया का लीफ जो है वो बाइपिनेटली कंपाउंड है, इट इज बाइपिनेटली कंपाउंड, ठीक है। जस्ट एन ऑब्जर्वेशन, जस्ट मेकिंग यू रियलाइज दैट समटाइम्स यू कैन पिक अप दीज पॉइंट्स फ्रॉम इवन इमेजेस एंड डायग्राम्स विच आर नॉट मेंशन्ड। So if an image or a diagram in NCERT, you know, shows a particular point but not mentioned, you have to pick up these small things, right? And make a mental note of them. So all these three, entire leaf becoming a spine, the margin of leaf becoming spine, and the stipule modifying into spine, all these three modifications basically are for the purpose of reducing or eliminating the process of transpiration to save water and thereby help the plant. The fourth spine, stipule modifies to spine to protect the plant from grazing. Yahan pe the stipule is modifying into spine for transpiration. Yahan pe the stipule modifying into spine for protect the plant from grazing. Now, can you have these small structures? Dikh rahe chote chote structures? In case of Sisyphus, right? Sisyphus pehle bhi aaya tha apne ko, venation wale point mein aaya tha. If you remember, okay. So these are the four, examples that we have where the leaf is modifying itself into a spine, right? We go to the second modification. The second modification is a leaf tendril, right? Leaf tendril already humne padha hai stem tendril mein. Revise kar lenge, right? Plants having weak stem. Either the entire leaf or a part of the leaf gets modified into an elongated, thin, cylindrical, coiled, wiry, sensitive structure known as tendril. Right? Stem, I already shown you what's an image of a tendril, so I am not going to, talk about it again. Again, the purpose of the tendril remains the same. Right? Now, purpose kya rahega? Support. Weak stem hai na? To support ke liye. Let's see some instances where the leaf is modifying into a tendril. The entire leaf becoming tendril. Lathyrus, right? Na, it's a wild pea, right? Jo pisum sativa mein wo garden pea, sweet pea hai wo. This is Lathyrus. This is a wild pea. Ye dekho yahan par. The entire leaf has become tendril. Ye niche stipules jo hai wo leafy ho gaye. They do photosynthesis then. Okay. Second example. Terminal leaflets become tendril in case of Pisum sativum, right? Yaad hai na, Mendel wala plant, right? Pisum sativum ko bahut dhyan se padhna. Till the end of the chapter, this example is going to repeat, right? And it's going to become a really good friend of ours. Look at this image of a leaf of a Pisum. Can you see that this is now the rachis? Right? Can you see the leaflets? Right? Now, मतलब ये एक leaf है पूरा, and it is divided into leaflets. मतलब ये कौन से type का compound leaf है? Isn't this pinnately compound? Because the leaflets are attached to the rachis. And look at these terminal leaflets. आगे के तीन, right? Have they been converted into thin, cylindrical, coiled, wiry structures called tendrils? So terminal leaflets become tendril. Third instance. The stipules become tendril, right? Now, pehle humne dekha stipule becoming spine. Now, the stipule becoming tendril. Smilax. So, this is the stipule. Ye normal tumhara lamina hai. This is the stipule becoming the tendril. In all the three instances, can you see, ye stem jo hai na, bada weak hai. So, it is for the purpose of supporting the stem. And lastly, the leaf tip becomes tendril. In case of gloriosa, right? Can you see a curved line structure? So the tip of the leaf is turning into a tendril. So we had four instances of leaf modifying into spine. We have got four instances of leaf becoming a tendril also. The third modification is a leaf hook. Right? Have a look at this. In the plant Bignonia, Yungus cati, right? Now, Yungus cati ka matlab hota hai cat snail, right? The terminal three leaflets, wapis se terminal three, matlab leaf kaun sa ho gaya? Compound. So, agar question mein, DCT mein puchtu bhai, Bignonia ka leaf kaisa hai? Simple hai, compound hai. So, it should not be an out of syllabus question, right? Now, terminal three leaflets, ye dekho. Can I see leaflets here? Can I see the three terminal leaflets modifying? ये देखो, can I see the three terminal leaflets? Right na? So three terminal leaflets, they get modified into three stiff curved pointed hook like structures, like that of a cat snail, right? That's called as a leaf hook. Again, it is for to cling to the bark of the tree for support and to climb up, right na? So tendril wiry structure ban ke support karega. Yahan par the hook is attaching to the bark and helping the plant to climb up, right? And the last modification of leaf is a phyllode, right? Aagya wapis tumko pareshan karne ke liye. In the stem, we had a phylloclad, we had a cladode, right? We had cladophyll, and now this is a phyllode, right? Phyll se start hota hai, matlab definitely leaf ka structure, right? Now, always remember phyllode. Let's have a look at it. In some plants, right? Example देके बात कर देना. Acacia, auriculiformis. The petiole becomes flat green. अब देखो ये normal leaves है. Are the leaves reduced? मैंने बताया था वो bipinnately compound है acacia का leaf, right ना? So what will happen? Transpiration prevent करने के लिए वो bipinnate leaf भी गिर जाएगा, right ना? तो फोटोसिंथेसिस कौन करेगा? ये जो पार्ट दिख रहा तुमको क्या लिखा? देखो मॉडिफाइड लीफ स्टॉक. लीफ स्टॉक मतलब क्या? पीटीओल. सो पीटीओल इज बिकमिंग फ्लैट एंड ग्रीन लाइक. पीटीओल इज बिकमिंग फ्लैट एंड ग्रीन लाइक एंड डूइंग द पर्पस ऑफ फोटोसिंथेसिस. सो दिस पर्टिकुलर ग्रीनिश पीटीओल इज कॉल्ड एज अ फाइलोड. इट्स कॉल्ड एज अ फाइलोड, राइट? द नॉर्मल लीफ इज बाइपिनेटली कंपाउंड. देखो आ गया यहाँ पे एंड फॉल्स ऑफ सून. The petiole gets modified into phyllode. This is a xerophytic adaptation to reduce transpiration, right? So four modifications of leaf we have done, friends, right? Now the first was a leaf spine, the second was a leaf tendril, the third was a leaf hook, and the fourth one is a phyllode, right? This finishes our entire discussion on the topic of leaf, right? Okay. Thank you so much.